very good morning to you from New York, a good evening to those in other time zones, or good afternoon. It's a great honor to be joining you for this session of the Horacis Extraordinary Forum on the theme of celebrating the 75th anniversary of the UN and multilateralism in times of COVID. They called for the Secretary General to come back with proposals to upgrade the United Nations, to better serve the aspirations of people, and to make it more apt for current and future challenges. We need to build on the global demand to respond more coherently and better together to the current and urgent future needs. We need to show greater care across borders and generations for the planet we will hand over to future generations. How can we focus better on what unites us rather than investing so much in what divides us? How can we revitalize multilateralism against the backdrop of COVID? These are key questions of our time. I now have the honor to turn to the President of Armenia, His Excellency, Mr. Armen Sarkisyan. Mr. President, the floor is yours.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Undersecretary. And Fabrizio, I would like to start saying thank you to Horacis that has organized this virtual meeting, and of course to United Nations and you personally that you have been engaged now in this dialogue. Indeed, 75 years. For me, United Nations, except being what it is, and for the whole planet as an international huge organization, the biggest one, it is also a creation of humanity. We should also thank United Nations not only for the platform that has created for all nations to have this important dialogue to each other, but also for everyone and each problem that United Nations has helped to resolve. Every and each conflict that United Nations had helped to prevent, every each nation or nationality that had the inspiration of getting to a different life, of being the owners and the rulers of their own fate, and the United Nations has helped them to become a member of the international community. So there are many things that United Nations has done in health, in education, in arts, sciences, technology. So when I think about United Nations, this is an organization that should be the organization that should be given multiple Nobel Prizes and recognize the wonderful job that United Nations has done during all of these years. But of course, always there is the question, so after 75 years of our experience, where do we go now? Where is the next step, or where is the next direction? And when I think about United Nations today and the United Nations in the future, two words come to my thoughts. And one of them is the classical one, and that classical one is dialogue. Because that was the base of United Nations, bringing all of the different states together for a dialogue, and through dialogue resolve the problems that different nations, regions are facing. So going for the next 75 years, I don't think that we have to change it, because there is nothing better than dialogue that we can create, even in the new world. So the second word that comes to my mind is new world, or you can say welcome to the new world. So I think in order to have a United Nations that will be as effective as the previous 75 years in the next one, we have to understand that the next 75 years, this world is going to be different. The United Nations as an organization should stay. It should continue exercising dialogue, but in a completely different world, which is, sometimes I call it quantum world. My message here is, welcome to the new world, and this new world is not classical. So many things have changed. So where is the challenge here? And the challenge is, of course, to keep United Nations as the most valuable creation that we have done during the last 75 years, but to modernize it, bring it, to make it sort of a quantum, not classical in the sense that the United Nations, its organization, be that education, health, it's just there, all other platforms will be going in harmony with the changes of this new world. And of course, the second world dialogue stays as the most important one. And to be honest, as a president of the Republic of Armenia, today I'm just facing a big lack of it, of dialogue. Why? Because our neighbor Azerbaijan, that had a problem with Nagorno-Karabakh, and there with both sides were using, or the both sides of the conflict, because Nagorno-Karabakh has decided to live a free life through a referendum, like in sort of a normal 20th century world. But the reaction from Azeri side was a war in early 90s. Soviet republics, each of them declared that the empire is gone, now each of us can declare that we are independent. Nagorno-Karabakh was a part of Azerbaijan only for 70 years and because of the empire. The previous thousands of years it was a part of Armenia and it was always inhabited only by Armenians. So Comrade Stalin gave it to Azerbaijan, fine. After the breakdown of Soviet Union, Nagorno-Karabakh decided to become independent, but the reaction was not 20th century, it was a little bit medieval. But there was an organization, OSCE Minsk Group, and they were negotiating. There was a dialogue that was, I was hoping that the dialogue eventually will take us to the final resolution of the conflict, because that's the human spirit which is sitting as the core of United Nations as well. But 27th of September, Azerbaijan decided that they will try to resolve this issue not by dialogue but by a gun. And the unfortunate thing is now on the Azeri side, Turkey has been involved heavily using their means in order to bombshell Armenian, not only the borders and the fighters or the army of Nagorno-Karabakh, but also civilians. It reminds me of something which is one calls an ethnic cleansing. And as an Armenian, every and each time I see Turkey going into battle, it takes me back 105 years ago when at the end of Ottoman Empire there was the Armenian genocide. So the call is, yes, the world is new. Yes, there is nothing better that we have than United Nations. Yes, there is only one way to resolving all our problems, and that's a dialogue. And dialogue is a big word connected to United Nations. So we should continue dialogue in this new world with your new forms. Well, I can continue more. I am the former professor, and it will take your 45 minutes. So I stop here. Thank you, Fabrizio.
Excellency, for those insightful words and the stress on both ensuring that good old-fashioned dialogue remains a dominant part of our international affairs, the dominant part of our international affairs, while we also need to modernize and adapt to the new world you so eloquently described.